Good morning, everybody. My name is Paul Wellborn, and this is Faith Baptist Church Sunday School. I say this every time. I think you guys know who I am, but just in case, if we have anybody that's new, you'll know who I am. But welcome. We're going to be looking at Matthew chapter 24. Matthew 24 is known as the Olivet Discourse. Jesus was speaking on the Mount of Olives, which when we think of mountains here, you might think of Grandfather Mountain or Mount Mitchell or even Pilot Mountain. But in this case, it's kind of a large hill is the way the topography is in Israel. So if you've ever been to Arizona or New Mexico and you've seen how brown and rocky things are, that's basically kind of what this was. And so Jesus is up on an elevated area and he's speaking to a group of people. And so that's the context here in Matthew chapter 24. And really the point of the lesson is explaining the second advent. And advent, which is based on the Latin word adventus, it literally means arrival. And when we think of Advent, we think of Christmas time. At Christmas, we light white candles and a pink candle and a purple candle. Some churches have Advent services each week leading up to Christmas. And so the first Advent is known as Christmas, Jesus's arrival on earth. And so we are going to be looking at the second Advent, the second coming of Christ. Some people get it confused and they think about the rapture is the actual second coming, but really the second coming, second advent is after the rapture, and we're going to explain that. So Matthew chapter 24, verses 3 through 8, and this is, while he was sitting on the Mount of Olives, Jesus, the disciples approached him privately and said, and have you ever had like an event happen and things kind of settle down and then you go up to the pastor, sometimes in between church services of faith, if you've had the morning church service and the second church service, you might have some time to go up and speak to Mickey, and you may say, hey, what was going on with that, or you know, what did you mean whenever you were speaking about this? And so they were meeting with Jesus, and it kind of calmed down, and they said, tell us, when will these things happen, and what will be the sign of your coming in the end of the age? And Jesus replied to them, watch out that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, saying, I am the Messiah. And they will deceive many. And this is true at this time. During this time period, people had appeared, and there had been Josephus, a secular historian, noted that there had been others that had claimed to be the Messiah who would deliver Israel. Especially during this time of Roman oppression, you had a lot of people seeking somebody to get them out of that situation. And so you're going to hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not alarmed, because these things must take place, but the end is not yet. For nation will rise up against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines and earthquakes in various places. And all these events are the beginnings of labor pains. And you think, okay, right now, can it get any worse? And, you know, during the first part of the pandemic last year, they talked about you might have a lot of cases that show up and that sort of thing. And then after you have the high case count, then you would have a lot of hospitalizations. And then after the hospitalizations, you would have people that would, you know, there would be deaths and that sort of thing that would be affected by that. And so I see that. I work closely with a local hospital, and we do see there being kind of a trend where it goes up, and you think, okay, well, the numbers are going back down, but then the hospitalizations kind of creep back up, and folks have to be treated in the hospital. And so you have kind of that, okay, it's going to get a little worse, and it sounds kind of negative. It's like, okay, it's going to get worse before it gets better, but that happens in life, and many other situations are like that. And so Jesus is saying in this case, yeah, there's going to be some bad things that happen, and it's not yet going to be as worse as it's going to get. And so, goodness. And again, you think about now, and you look back in history, and there's been multiple times in history when folks have thought, well, the rapture is nigh, you know, using old-timey language. I remember 88 reasons in 1988 that the Bible is, or that Jesus is going to come back. And there's 88 reasons this guy came up with and published a book in 1988. And I remember people getting real hyped up about it. Yeah, this makes sense. Look at this. You have Europe doing this, and you have these things happening. And I see things happening myself. I see basically, and not to get too political, but the mentioning about vaccine passes and those sort of things where you can't go to a certain area unless you present a vaccine pass. And I'm not saying a vaccine pass is the mark of the devil, mark of the beast. So make sure and hear me very clearly. But what I am seeing is certain things being set into motion and being placed that to where, like Revelation chapter 13, verse 18, that prophecy where basically it says you were not able to buy or sell, you won't be able to buy or sell things unless you have a certain mark. And that is the mark of the beast in that case. But I do see certain things happening and being put in place that will fit into future events and biblical prophecy. I'm not saying Jesus is going to come back tomorrow or, you know, in 12 months or whatever. I don't know. But just pointing that out. So you're going to hear wars, rumors of wars, earthquakes, and a lot of things. Now, I want to make it also very clear. In this chapter, theologians, and I looked at multiple commentaries, do feel that the rapture, the church being taken away from the earth, those of you who are believers, it's going to happen during the first few verses of Matthew chapter 24. And you have, and I jotted down some notes, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, also chapter 10, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, Revelation 3, all those chapters mention the church being taken away from the earth prior to the seven-year tribulation. So there's going to be a rapture, 7 years of tribulation, and then Jesus' second advent at the end of the tribulation, and Christ's saints, those of us who are going to be raptured, are going to return with Christ at the end of the 7 years, and then there's going to be a thousand-year millennium. So anyway, that I wanted to go ahead and kind of spell out there. And if we continue on in Matthew chapter 24, verses 29 through 32, later on in the chapter, immediately after the stress of those days, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not shed its light. The stars will fall from the sky, and the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in the sky, and all the people of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds in heaven, with power and great glory. He will send out his angels with a loud trumpet, and they will gather his elect from the four winds, from one end of the sky to the other. Learn this lesson from the fig tree. As soon as its branch becomes tender and sprouts leaves, you will know that summer is near. I love figs. I have a fig bush in my backyard, and whenever it goes dormant in the wintertime, it looks dead. It just has nothing. It's a very ugly looking structure. And it takes a while for leaves to start to appear. And many times whenever I first had this, I thought, okay, did it die over the wintertime? And it's like, you know, later in March whenever it starts to get green, and then by summertime it's a flourishing shrub or a bush. Jesus was giving the analogy of Israel was going to be like that. And remember the context. He's speaking to people of Hebrew descent. And he's telling them this. Now, when it talks about the sun and the moon being darkened and those sort of things, that's during the tribulation. And at the second advent, there's going to be a sign in the sky whenever Jesus returns. And think about it. The first advent, we had the Star of Bethlehem. And so I don't know if it's going to be something like that, the Shekinah glory or some kind of bright something in the sky, but Jesus himself said there's going to be a sign that's going to be given. And so Matthew 24, verses 42 through 44, therefore be alert, since you do not know what day the Lord is coming. But know this, that if the homeowner had known what time the thief was coming, he would have stayed alert and not let his house be broken into. This is why you should always be ready, because the Son of Man is coming at the hour you do not expect. There's it's called a Nextdoor app. It's kind of a neighbor type thing, and people can post things in there and say, you know, okay, I saw a shady car driving around the neighborhood or whatever. Be on alert. And so every once in a while, folks will post on that. And you think about it, those of you who've ever had somebody break into your house or break into your car, gosh, many years ago, this was in the late 90s, my old Nissan truck, the blue 86 that I still have. I got a nice radio from a friend of mine, and it was up at on North Main Street at the Chamber of Commerce up there, and I went in for something, came back out, and the thing had been yanked out of the dash. And, you know, if you know an 86 Nissan truck, it's pretty easy to steal a radio out of it. Basically, you grab two ends and pull really hard, and you can just yank it out. Never had anything stolen from me until that point like that, where it was like, wow, somebody actually opened up my door, got in my truck, and pulled the radio out. And it was kind of a weird feeling. If I'd known that somebody was going to do that, I would have locked the door and, you know, been more aware of it. But I quickly went in, shut the door, didn't even think about it, came back out, and somebody must have been sitting out in the parking lot watching and just thought, that's the easy target. Again, you know, they got a really nice cassette player. So Jesus, with his parable, is saying, we don't know whenever Christ is going to return. He was speaking about himself. You know, whenever I come back to the earth, we don't know. And there's going to be the rapture, 7 years of tribulation, and then you're going to have the second advent. So that's the main point of this lesson this morning. It's a Sunday school lesson. It's an education lesson. For us, the application really is to be aware, to think about our lives, and how are we telling people about Jesus. Next week, we're going to be looking at the Great Commission, Matthew 28, telling people about Jesus. But with this, it's more of an educational, okay, when you hear people say the second coming of Jesus, when's that going to be, or the rapture, just be aware the rapture is going to happen first. We don't know when. And then all these prophetic things that we see now during the tribulation are really going to ramp up. It's really going to be bad. But the church isn't going to be there, those of you who trust in Christ. And then at the end of the seven-year tribulation, you're going to have Christ return to earth, the second advent. Hope that made sense. Hope everybody has a great week ahead. Look forward to seeing you next week at our next Sunday school lesson.